It is widely accepted amongst scientists and economists that even with our best attempts to reduce emissions, climate change will cause widespread damage and loss to both human and natural ecosystems. It will have a particularly profound impact on the world's poorest people, who are financially limited in their ability to adapt to and recover from threats such as increased heat waves and floods. Governments around the world, therefore, acknowledge the need to develop adaptation policies to increase resilience to climate change. So what is climate change adaptation? The United Nations defined it as actions taken to help communities and ecosystems cope with changing climate conditions. In a nutshell, adaptation aims to reduce the economic, social, and environmental loss and damage caused by climate change. Adaptation actions vary widely and include strategic policies and projects covering water, agriculture, infrastructure, human health, tourism, transport and energy. For example, governments might impose restrictions on coastal development where sea level rise could have an impact on infrastructure. Irrigation efficiency in agriculture may be targeted to aid in drought-proofing and food security. Installing seawalls or rehabilitating mangroves can buffer against the impacts of sea level rise and storm surges. And diversifying a region's energy generation mix ensures it is not dependent on just one source of supply. This is an important adaptation strategy in the case of severe weather events, which can result in damaged infrastructure and cuts to power supply. Adaptation and mitigation are inherently linked. Mitigation now reduces the future need for adaptation. In his 2007 review, English economist Sir Nicholas Stern estimated that without strong mitigation action, the overall costs of climate change impacts will be equivalent to losing at least 5% of global gross domestic product each year. Although the Stern review was criticised by some experts, it was widely heralded as a landmark report, as it brought attention to the potential loss and damage of climate change in the future. Undertaking adaptation measures now supports future financial resilience, which increases our capacity to continue to mitigate emissions. However, adaptation will have a cost. So how much money needs to be invested in adaptation to protect people and businesses, particularly in the developing world, from the worst impacts of climate change? According to the World Resources Institute, the developing world will require between 140 and 300 billion US dollars per year by 2050 to adapt to climate change. Some experts also predict that this amount could double or triple every few years if mitigation action stalls and the impacts of climate change become worse than expected. With that in mind, how much money are we currently spending on adaptation? Well, the Climate Policy Initiative estimates that of the $391 billion US dollars that flowed to climate change-related projects in 2014, only 7%, or just $25 billion US dollars, went to adaptation. Mobilising additional finance for adaptation is therefore a pressing challenge for developing countries, if they are to buffer the worst impacts of climate change. Delaying action will mean even higher adaptation costs in the future. It's not only governments who are recognising the potential impact of climate change and the need for adaptation actions. Companies around the world are already implementing their own adaptation projects, irrespective of any government policies. For example, Nestlé, the world's largest food company, is providing training to cocoa farmers to improve the water and fertilizer efficiency of their crops. This is in response to the increasing droughts and water scarcity that pose a major risk to Nestlé's supply chain. The company is also investing in the research and development of stronger, more disease-resistant cocoa plants. Through these climate adaptation actions, Nestlé is working to ensure the reliable future supply of the cocoa beans that are essential to its business. Financial markets and the insurance industry are also becoming increasingly wary. Key infrastructure assets, such as roads and industrial facilities located in high-risk zones, are directly impacted by more frequent and often more violent storms, storm surges, and wildfires. As a consequence, assets that remain exposed to climate change are also attracting higher insurance premiums and potentially even losses in asset value. As the world continues to warm, the need for adaptation will only increase. Understanding the adaptation options a country and an organisation has and how financing can be obtained is a critical step in helping vulnerable communities and businesses overcome the threats that climate change poses.